Today, we're broadcasting from Palo Alto, California, in the very heart of the Silicon Valley. Palo Alto has been the birthplace of some of the world's leading technology and life science companies, making Palo Alto the startup capital of the world.
Hi there, I'm Louis Lehot, the founder of L2 Counsel, and welcome to another edition of Ask a Silicon Valley Lawyer. Today, I want to talk about how to pick an investment banker. You've been planning for this moment a long time. And in your board meeting or in the marketplace, you believe now is the time to sell your company. Do you need an investment banker? Have you received an inbound and somebody's been knocking on your door and giving you your dream price? Perhaps you do, perhaps you don't. If you do, following are some tips on how to make the very best selection of an investment banker that's right for you. Like any market, the investment banker market is heavily stratified, according to bankers that really know your space, your industry vertical, and who know how to do deals in the range of values that you're going to be looking at for your company. There are big names that you may have heard of, and those might be right for you if you're looking at a billion-dollar sale. But if you're looking to sell your company in a $10 to $30 million range, that big name brand that you've heard of may not be the right fit for you, either because of their minimum fee, because of the percentage of consideration that they'd be looking for in a sale, and most importantly, because given that the majority of the transactions they work on are at this price point, they're probably not going to spend a lot of time on a transaction in this price point. Today, I'm going to talk to you about how to select an investment banker to sell your business. The first question we get to before that, however, is do you need one at all? A lot of companies come to me with a term sheet that's come in over the transom from a competitor, a private equity buyer. It's their dream price. They've had several discussions. Perhaps there's not a need for an investment banker if you have a solid legal and accounting team to back you up and take you through the diligence process, and if the buyer is an experienced buyer who knows how to get a deal done. However, if you're looking to go and discover what's the best price for you and the best price for your business, you probably will need the help of an investment banker. Not all are created equal, and not all are right for you, even if they're great. So there are probably some large bulge bracket investment banking names that we've all heard of that bring companies out public, and they're fantastic. But if you're selling your business in a range of 10 to 50 to even $100 million, perhaps you'll get better attention, better service, and perhaps there is an investment banker who has much greater expertise in your industry vertical, in your geography, and who knows the universe of potential buyers better than anyone else. So certainly it is not about brand, it's about who can deliver the most value for you. I want to talk about three ways that you can select an investment banker and lock in an engagement. First, obviously, everyone asks, what's the right fee? And that's going to depend on your on all of those things that we've already talked about, industry vertical, the amount of consideration that you're looking for, and perhaps incentives that you want to set up to incentivize your investment banker to get you to the right fee. Those are all things that are legitimate questions that can be negotiated in the course of the engagement. They will also want a tail period, which means that if they're terminated, or if the engagement expires and then you sell afterwards within some period of time, whether it's 6, 12, or 24 months, they still get the right to their fee. And the theory there is that all of the activity and the introductions that they make may just not yield fruition until after their engagement expires and that they've still earned their fee. So that's an important thing to think about, consider, and negotiate. The second thing is looking at other companies in your sector that have been sold to the types of buyers that you're looking for and which investment bank has been part of that transaction. So if you're looking to sell to a company that starts with G and an investment bank that starts with Q has sold several companies to a company that starts with G, perhaps it's good to be talking to that investment bank that starts with a Q because they really know G, they know how to sell to them, they know the players, they know the process. These are all important considerations. Finally, I would say I would really want to know how many companies have been sold by this investment bank in the in the range of prices that you're thinking of, and what were the issues that they attacked and came up. So for example, if you think that an earnout is going to be needed to sell your business, does this investment bank have experience negotiating earnouts? And not only negotiating them, making sure that they get paid. Sticking with you all the way through the timeline of your transaction, which oftentimes doesn't end at closing, it ends 3 years later when your last earnout gets paid. A word about relationships. An investment banker may have relationships with venture capitalists on your board, potential buyers, private equity players. Some people are suspicious of these relationships. I think you should welcome them. A good investment banker is going to have good relationships across the ecosystem of players in the market, and all of that will be brought to your benefit. Remember, the investment banker only gets paid if you get a transaction. Now, maybe there's a retainer of some kind, depending on the size of your deal. So I don't mean that there's zero consideration, but the real carrot for an investment banker is a transaction getting signed and closed. And so that the fact that they have relationships with your venture capitalists is not something that you should be afraid of. In fact, you should welcome it, because that means they probably have some trust with your venture capitalists. And when they come to your board and say, this is the best price, you have a better chance of getting to yes. One thing that I spend a lot of time on when I look at engagement letters for investment bankers are the scope of services that they're going to provide. This is really important to have a very frank exchange of views and a good understanding of the types of support that you're going to receive from your investment banker, whether it's putting together a financial model, whether it's putting together a waterfall, adjusting the waterfall for various different scenarios, putting together your confidential info memo, accompanying you to meetings. These are all important things that you want your investment banker to be helping you with to get to the best deal. Once you get to a term sheet, many investment bankers will punch out and just call the lawyer once a week and ask, when is the deal getting signed and closed? Well, that's probably not the right investment banker for you. You're going to want somebody that's going to help you maintain the data room, keep good discussions going on with the buyer, check in at regular points with the buyer and make sure that they're moving as quickly as they should be and under the circumstances towards a signing and then towards a closing. How else can they be helping you? Can they be helping you with the waterfall? Can they be helping you with funds flow? These are all things that good investment bankers do to make sure transactions happen smoothly and get to closing. Final word about investment bankers: this is somebody you're going to be spending a lot of time with. So you want to make sure that the person that's selling you is going to be the person that's going to be with you all along and every stage of the way. Of course, they're going to have a team and you're going to want to meet them as well. And you're going to want to make sure there's good synergy between you and the lead and the other members of the team, because it's working together that brings you the best transaction. Thanks for joining another episode of Ask a Silicon Valley Lawyer. If you have any questions about how to engage an investment banker, don't hesitate to reach out. I'm Louis Lehot, and thanks for joining.